to Berkeley, who come out onto court first. Captain Oliveira, Martinez, number two to the outside. Claudia setting number four. Nicole Fawcett, number 11, opposite slot. Carroll through the middle, number 15. Figueroa, 16. So it's the Sally lineup. Wonderful guy, lovely chap, great coach. It's going to be tough one against Tianjin Bohai Bank and a huge draw for Xu Ting as she goes out into court. She's going through the outside. Li Yingying is the other outside hitter. Number one, Destiny Hooker, number nine, is in the opposite slot. Yuan Xinyue, number 12, has been a blocking. Yuan, number 15, has been Yao Di, number 16, is the setter. This is how they're lining up. Starting position 3, the starting lead round is going to be number 10. Chen Yu Xian is the head coach. Six. It's tough competition. So national team. Tianjin Bohai Bank in red serving. And it is Dintil Prekul of Brazil, number one receiving in the first court, goes the way of the home team. As they've got the ace. Yingying will serve again. Brilliant start. More home side. And then again under pressure. There's no trouble putting that on the floor. Ball in from Braylin. Might stay in play, does stay in play. Well done by Hooker. And in the end, the ball goes down on the floor. With a bit of work to do, does it well. Soutine just wondered whether or not she could see that rail in. Hadn't closed the gap between herself and the net because that's the player she targeted. The ball goes down on the side of Dentil. Xinyue, Chinese national team player. Again, Dentil looking to get three blockers out against Soutine. Which is all well and good, but you've then got a cover right behind you. What a bring your player at four. Four out to cover that big gap. Force it now. Anna Karolina. Soutine is playing with his Dentil block at the moment. See why Tianjin are going after Martinez in serve where they can. They don't want her to be out of hits. They don't want her to be out of that kind of ball. Because when she does, she's pretty much unstoppable. Braylin touched that, stood on the floor. And if she had just decided to go on a tippy toe, she actually made the block, which may well have resulted in to take the point. As it is, it's Chino Habit. Hocker putting it on the floor. The two opposites now are really embroiled in a good game here. Both former USA national team players, Destiny Hooker and Nicole Fawcett, still going strong, still showing the skills that play the girls. Oh, that's a stinger. Valeska going down the line on that slide and she's caught the Libra Lee Li Wan right in the face. She does apologise, it's a bit expert. Yeah. shooting, but what works well for Dentier. We'll go to the 10th for a timeout. Brazilian team leading by one.
安德烈也是特别感谢五月龙山乐饮本次大赐的点评支持。五月龙山让造美好生活，浙江五月龙山首席酒股份有限公司指中国最大规模的黄酒企业，近拥有国家黄酒工程技术研究中心和26万千升的陈酒储量。 聚集两名中国酿酒大师13名国家级啤酒大师和众多的酿酒高手，黄酒年产量达到16余万吨，旗下又有五月龙山、陈永和、李远红、状元红、建湖等众多的黄酒知名品牌。
That Tianjin Bank take where two players are closing the gap between themselves and the net. It's a touch for the hooker. Free ball there though for Dentiel. Three front court options plus. Lovely ball in from Sueli Pinto. And then the slide behind, too quick. No chance to do anything about it, but that's not going to serve. Still going strong, 14 years of age. Incredible effort. This goes for the Brazil international. She did have a season in Brazil in 2010 with Itambé Minas, the other Brazilian club batter here. He went to Puerto Rico, actually also played for Guangdong Evergrande, another team that's here. Really good pick up there. Free ball though for Dentiel. Another massive swing. This time Carroll blistering the ball down the line. Oh goodness me. You can just see that was the swing from Valeska earlier, but the libero got in the face. And her eyes closing up. She struggles to see anything. That is not good at all for Liu Liwen. a pick up from Sue Ellen Pinto. That's magnificent. Really good example of just how hard and fast the ball travels from the end on camera. And also how quickly it's sent out wide. Another good touch from Sue Ellen, but it's not managed to pop by anybody else. Touch that. Dentil's way, is it? I think I'm going to check here. No touch! No touch, that's out off the block. Vocal. She's just come back from a knee operation. He was hobbling around in Japan at the World Cup with a walking stick. Fully recovered. Touch against Dentil. You've got to be careful when you make that kind of movements going forward. Completely dismissive, Valeska. You've got to be careful though. Sometimes, it seems odd, but it does happen. Players are touching that, don't even notice they've done it. Hawkeye from the right angle to see where the net touch was, and it has to be the player moving to the net and touching the net. If the player's there and the net touches the player because the ball hits it and then hits them, that's not a net fault. So it has to be very clear that the player is moving towards the net and touches it as a result of that move. If you went up and you're blocking and you're above the net, the net's been caught by the ball or it's been bouncing, the net comes up and hits you, and you're above it, would that be a net touch? It would be a touch, but would it go against you? Figure out. a situation where that might happen. That's why she said she did. But she has touched it, and she's touched it with her clothing. Well, there is. Well, Barros is going crazy. He's saying no touch, but he has touched it. The shirt of Valeska has touched the net. And they're claiming no touch, and it's quite clearly showing that. But the other question is, though, well, is the ball net? Whilst there's a net touch, the other thing, though, is was the ball down? That's the other thing they have to check. You do need to make sure of that, that net touch happened after the ball, oh, sorry, happened before the ball has hit the floor. They haven't shown that. Kang's going for the cards, but that's really not the way to do it. We know there was a net touch, that we can see, which some Barros is saying hasn't happened. But the question is, which we haven't been able to see, was the ball still in play? Barros has to be careful now, though, even though they're getting a card. There was a net touch, no question of that. The only unclear bit is whether or not that ball was still in play. But it's done and dusted now, the point's gone to Tianjin Bank. Might be a better chance for Tianjin Bank to have a sweep. Somehow that's gone through the block, through the defence, and missed the court. Into the technical timeout. Just 1 minute. Just a couple of minutes has gone. Deep jump serve, well passed. No one covering in. It's a big gap for that ball to be placed into, which was expertly done. Mixing up her shots well. Substitution. Michelle Pavao. Outside hitter. Serve. timing was all wrong. Somehow kept in play, but not any longer. Chen Jin getting themselves in front, getting to that magic 21-point mark, which is quite crucial, statistically speaking, in this sport. It's more often than not, when you get the 21, you're going to go and take the set. Cole will force it. Return and stand around. Take away now to serve. A little too much on that, looking for that little space, but plenty on it in block. Tianjin as in comes Yu Junwei. Opening set. Oscar taken out of the action. Really good pickup. Able to go under the net as long as the feet don't go under and you don't impede what's happening on the other side. So play continues. Su Ting finishes off the rally. Tianjin now have set points. Asking with their block defense, Tianjin take the first set here against Din Tiel. Giving Tianjin three extra points in errors. Until they attack Tianjin. Those stats still didn't pay off. Tianjin have been serving. They've had a couple of aces, one short and then one in between the two passes in the seam, but for the most part they've been taking the front court swing, which has mostly been Braylon. Braylon started her career with Julie. 2009, clubs within Dominican Republic, then went to Verona Bolzano in 2015, from there to Busto Arsizio, then to Casamello Giuri, that's the last club for this World Club champs, and then from there went back to the Dominican Republic for Carabinas in 2017, before going to Turkey to play for BBSK, and then this season joining the Dinter Group. Second set underway. Silva with the serve. It's a good outlet on that rotation because Nicole Fawcett's not going to pass the ball, but starting in position four means that Braylin only has to focus on making the pass. Rossetta just giving the signals of where she wants her players to run. That's a great pickup. Wants a net touch, she's going to get it. Well, I've got to think that's pretty much the end of the set. When you look at the libero, number 10, we win for Chen Jin. She's got that ice on her eye, but it's completely closed up now. Thing that can sometimes get lost in the translation when you watch volleyball on television is the sheer brutality of it and the physicality of it. And you've got these players jumping across in the air and hitting the ball 40-50 miles an hour, even harder. It's game 190 kilometers an hour, which is just a lot. It's just phenomenal. It's incredible to watch when you get the opportunity to watch it live. It's a sport like no other volleyball. Actions, the thinking, you're working in three dimensions. Playing a moving ball as well. Every time is different. Every contact is different. Every rally is different. Every time you go and serve the ball, it's different. Just missing her mark at the moment. And that allows Tintil to come in there. And that's so good. You think, look at that. That's a fantastic shot. Shooting above the height of the net, above Braylin in swing. Interesting. Hit that ball with what looked like to be the heel of her hand. Maybe right. It went out. Chase the ball and try and bring it back if it goes onto the other side of court, outside of the antenna. And then you'd have to bring it back outside of the antenna. During that process, you're not allowed to stop her from doing that. You're not allowed to tension getting away, and you're not allowed to touch the ball either. As an opposition, and that includes coaching staff. Says the lines judge. Yeah, we'll put it on it. We'll commit in the middle of that by Valeska. Oh. lovely pick up. It's Hooker who puts the ball down. Tianjin who stay in front. Interestingly, Savantis makes that error, just looking at Destiny Hooker, she's taped up the top, so that she doesn't keep pulling her sleeve up. Hooker used to do that a lot, so on the 3 metre line, and it is Nicole Fawcett on the 3 metre line, and as a background player, to take off from behind it. It's not going to be allowed, even though it was a good effort. This Hooker went under the net. Stepped into court. She's only a pound, so stick with the opposition court to go and chase it. From Braley. Till beginning the fight back now in this set. Unlucky for Tianjin. It's an ace for Martinez. Martinez doesn't use her arm swing as effectively as she could. She has the arm swing that you sometimes see middle blockers have. Doesn't have a full extension of the arm back and up. That's a product of being tall from a young age and relying on the fact that you're already quite high. It does have an effect with her jump serve. She has to contact the ball as high as she can, which is why sometimes it clips the net. Work that block. It's not getting any better anytime soon, certainly not for this game. Wasn't there for Braylin to chase and have a swing on. And go and get that. Sierra Pinto was still moving backwards as that ball was hit off the block, so then couldn't change her momentum and go and chase the ball to the left. So important. One of the most difficult things at times is to get into a neutral position from which you can then move to chase the ball. It's a good pass which opens up the court, but good defence from Suting. Finished off with a lovely swing by Li Yingying. Li and Co walk off court. Tanya Co vaporised her plans since 2002. The distinguished career she's had in Brazil, Japan, Turkey, Russia. Here in China as well, as with Guangdong last season, the team that also be in this World Cup Championship. It's too cheap, really high in control of well played from Yao Di to get into that position, to turn, to make the block without touching the net. Fegere kept her eye on what was going on to get the point. Teammates four behind to get some points from service. Still scoring Tianjin 2-1 where they can. Chance for a point here. It's going to be free ball though back to Tianjin, and they've got a better opportunity than they had in the last time. So Tianjin makes sure of it. Serve from Yao Di, dropping that ball just outside the 3 metre line towards that sideline. Martinez was unsure of what to do with it, didn't put any momentum forwards into the ball, and as a result gets aced. Great pick up from Hooker, turned around quickly, linked into what was going on. will do. Stop that one though. Dentil. Take a point. Wonderful pick up there. Just the marker. That's added value as an opposite player. Caught out by that serve. That's a fabulous block from Zuting. Classic blocking, really, in how to make a block up and across in the same motion, getting as close to the ball as possible as we enter the technical timeout. Changing leading by 5 and by 1-79. Dentil. Chichin did so well, particularly the setter, not to touch the net. D as she goes into play that. Unfortunately, it's Nicole Fawcett and Valeska touching the net. So Ting to serve. Got the shot from Martinez into the corner. Going off. Double substitution this. Dentil in the setter into the back row. Extra attacker in the front row. Martinho. Ananda is her first name. Ananda has on her shirt. Last name is Martinho. Shrugging off the ball. And again, Chanjin. Well, can't find a way through. Dentil fighting hard, but it's an unforced error up the door, is it? Given as a block touch. Sorry, Dempsey will be rewarded for that hard work. It's a good dig. Zuting also making a good dig on a ball that came off the block. Oh, well up by Suellen. But that was the carrot on the stick when that was touched by Martinez. No matter how fast people try to chase him, they're never going to catch him. Pickup. Free ball now for Dentil. Four attacking options. Oh, he's going to be faking Dentil in that situation, a 4-on-3 situation. So Fakeray able to have the swing to the line. Sheldon coming in to serve. Putting a hand out, a little bit of a little bit of confusion as to who's going to play it over. Doesn't mean you want to dig in the ball. Swing from Fegueray, Tianqi will be a little disappointed. Just leaving a massive gap between herself and the net. Virginia comes back in. Has had a few stints with the club over the years. In 2008, then went to Itambe, then went to Campinas, and then Sesi, then came back to them in 2015 before needing to go to Osasco and then come back again this season. Siding out once again. Shinway getting across Fegueray. Bit of movement there from Suting. Make the pass and then work in the combination. Just over the top of the Lee Quick. Time pressure on the block. Now D to serve. Hooker now into the front row with Suting. That's a good dig as well. That's a tricky one to have to deal with. Very little to no arm swing as well. She makes the dig. Look at that, there's no back lift at all of her arms. They're pretty much staying in front. She just drives up and swings through the ball. pick up. Touch from Hooker. There's a chance here now. Well taken. Challenge coming. And that was a good play to run the middle, actually, because Braylon was out trying to get back into. She couldn't help in the middle, so it opened up a good angle to go to that sideline. The question that we're going to find out is whether or not he just ran away. Challenge, apparently it's not working. Alabarros having a chat with the assistants that are around the court, so there are scouts around who are providing real-time information and so on about what's going on. And that one is Agnew, who did run away. It's a good challenge. Right. It was. Oh, cool. Style volleyball this year. It's prior to the Olympic Games, introduced at the World Cup in Japan. The new 18-paneled volleyball. Same colours, but different style. It's a slightly different shading in terms of where that blue pattern now goes. It's more yellow and a little bit of blue. And that supposedly makes it easier to see when it goes high up into this, towards the lights. Just trying to figure out where everybody is on court now. You have to go back. You have to go round one rotation in fact. For Michelle, so she's still on court because they won the point. So now they can make the transition because they, well, she'd done it a little bit outside, being picked up by the scores table. So that's okay. That's because they've gone round one. To serve. Hooker gets past Braylon. There's no set point for Churchill. With the serve. A little bit of hesitation then from Chen Jin, from Li Yingying to go after that one. So set point is saved. Lovely ball in. Good out from Fawcett. She's now out of the play. Faker A wasn't, but she doesn't find the court. The set goes to Churchill, 25-19. They lead Dentiel now by 2 sets to nothing. We'll be right back. Gentile up against it now, two sets behind to Tianjin. If they don't win this match, their chances of going into the semis are, well, all but over. Currently bottom of pool B, lost. Again, Chinjin also lost there, so neither one of these teams doesn't get the victory, they probably won't be going to the semis. But you're not seeing double, well, you kind of are seeing double for Gentile, the twin sisters. Michelle and Monique. Monique, the player who has been on your screens more than her sister for the national team. She's an amazing player. What Braylon can do naturally. Over the top of blocks. No problem at all on a high ball out wide. That's good covering by Fagare. That one put up into the rafters, well dealt with. Again, another free swing. Martinez getting sucked into what's happening in the middle of court. And as a result, Hooker has now had two free hits in this match. That won't stay in play. Better opening to this set for Gentile. Not much that Fagare could do with that. She did well to get it away from the block, but it was a free ball for Tianjin. So Tian puts that free ball in, and it's a free swing in the middle. Those kind of plays, even at this stage, give you massive confidence as a team. Double touch given. Sichuan, who has replaced Liu Liwen, has retired this one with a ball into her left eye, and it's swollen up so much it's closed up. Yeah. Towards that ball going out over the sideline. Carroll up early, able to unload on that ball as a result. Forced that ball to the middle, wasn't quite quick enough in order for a big swing to happen. Has that landed in? No. He's going to run on the sideline. Brady gets the point. It's a really good lead from Zhu Ting. The ball is high to her shoulder, forcing her backwards. She's having to be aware of that travelling ball, where she is spatially on the court and where that ball is going to land. Barosz wants to have a look though. Good lead from Zhu Ting. A challenge lost. Slowed down. Chin Chin go again. Oh, what a wonderful set that was. Absolutely brilliant set from Gao Di. Missing the ball out wide for Zhu Ting. That's quality. We watch that all day long, and then Zhu Ting with the easiest of jobs to wrap it off on the lock now. done. Vega Ray. Zhiting, good movement from her. Oh, so unlucky for Dentil. Suellen was chasing, she had it covered. And then running from position one, Claudia also thought she had it. Who would have got it? Well, Claudia touched it away from where Libra was starting from. Really good touch. So is that. That's landed in. That's a fantastic angle, is it? From Braylin, or is it not landed in? She thinks it is in. We might have another challenge coming. Marsh loses it. They'll have none. They won't have any more challenges available in this set. Don't believe that's ridiculous, isn't it? Yep, in's in, miles in. Carroll with the serve. So the national team player comes up with an ace, getting the better of Li Ying Ying. Team this time finds some space down the line. So good to have options available. Yuan Xinyue with the serve. Braylin under pressure, will get high and wide. And Su Ting makes a great dig cross court. Oh! Fabulous dig from Suellen. Well watched by Braylin. Dentil might have another chance here. Braylin. 1 foot Yahoo, still no good. Best chance of this rally. Oh yes, quality from Braylin. That's not 4-4. That is 4-2 within an inch from the net. You don't dig those. Fabulous swing. One. The challenge coming. That's not even close to being out, is it? There's a couple of hits. Must have been the speed of the serve. It's cool. It's serve then for Nicole Fawcett, looking for another. Net touch, I think, will there, no? That's time that Su Ting had one of those. She got the floor, they clip the net, so brought her hand back. That one was fine. It's on her side, which is just to have a Ibrahima still moving backwards, and then as the pace of the ball was reduced dramatically by clipping the top of the net, unable to go and chase after it, Ming. Sichuan. Gator from Nicole Fawcett. Big swing through the middle on that high from Braylon. Jiting's had that strapping on her right hand for so long now. That's just a heavy swing. It's point for point at the moment between these two teams. Foot, stay in play. No in-rally challenge coming from Tianjin, so play continues, and now Dentil can have a swing to take this point. Fakeray works the block and gets it. And we'll go to the second technical timeout. Dentil leading by two. Collins got a destination corruption also there. From Tianjin, because it committed in the middle, it was a really big swing from De Tiel. A really good commit block from Wang Xinyue to deny De Tiel. Metronome at the moment, backwards and forwards. Tianjin's defence has been really, really good. It is what's keeping them in this set, and actually now is to turn the tide in their favour, you feel. This is where they make their move now, Tianjin. thrilling finish to this set, that's for sure. Could well be the end of the match, depending how it goes. Tianjin now edging in front. From Valesco as well, that almost sigh of relief. From Valesco. It's a good touch and then block by Tianjin. Oh, it's another big hit from Hooker that doesn't find the baseline. Coming over 24 all here. Just a miss hit, really. The line was there to be hit. Up from Fawcett. Oh, oh dear. Oh, watching that ball, I hope they're okay. Just knew that was going to be danger. Two players going for the same ball. Fortunately, with Fawcett hitting into Braylin, knocking each other out of the way, not landing on each other's feet. Set point for Dentil. Pass from Xu Ting, but she's out of the attack. And Dentil now have a chance to take the set. Not going to miss that. Braylin puts it on the floor. And Dentil take the third set. They are back in this match here in Shaoxing.
Thank you.
Very different side mentally for Gentile in that last set. To that extra spike and to base. Go with the fourth set. Chen Jin starting brightly. Hooker with a really good swing cross court. Excellent spikes, but some equally great defense on both sides. But this is a bit of a worry for Chen Jin, because Hooker, who started this match very well, is beginning to make a few errors in key moments. But also in long rallies like that, when you want your big opposite to be able to put that ball on the floor. That helps Chen Jin with forcing. To find the court, giving the point to Churchill to work for it. Slightly wider than she wants to give Chen Jin opportunities to make digs. Struggling at the moment from the serving. ball here for Gentile. Interesting start to this fourth set with Xu Qing on the bench. From the inside is Wang Yisu. Xin Yuei goes back to serve. Just hope that Xu Qing's okay. Neutrals, why not? Five sets, brilliant. More volleyball to enjoy. Timeout. Gentile are in a really good place. Touch. That's fantastic play from Sue Ellen. Oh, what a pick up from Braylin. Clever from Fegare. Just kept it in play, making Chan Jin work again. And now a really good opportunity here. Braylin. Oh, well done by Hooker. Good up from Sue Ellen. What a rally. And it's a magnificent block in the end for Chan Jin to take the point. Thank you. 2 points in it still, but it's Dentil who have that lead. This goes on, the more Tianjin are going to be thinking this could be history repeating itself. They were 2-0 up against Novara in their first match and lost 3-2. Still, because Xu Qing got on court for whatever reason. Oh, that's brilliant reactions. So too from Braylin. There's no double touch on the first contact, and the ball goes over the net. Attempted swing from Claudinia. Good up from Hooker. Really good opportunity now for Dentil. Begaray. Oh, good pick up from Braylin. Good covering from her. And now the momentum swings towards Tianjin. Oh, what a block that is. What a way to win that point. Li Yingying must have thought she was going to get the point. Closing the cross court. Valeska. Fantastic. Forced out wide, but it'll do. Begaray gets that one to the floor. Good upswing from Begaray, high up into the air. effective in the women's game. Unfortunately by Wang Yizhu, just 18 years of age, born in 2001, 19 till March next year. He's been with Tianjin since 2017, so it's to the technical timeout. Dian Til with a healthy lead in this fourth set. To be messed with, showing Wang Yizhu hit a ball through four. But that was all down to some really good blocking by Dian Til. They were able to close down the gap, get a really good touch to slow the ball down and put it into transition. Good serving run this from Dian Til. Doesn't look to be anyway back here for Tianjin in this set. They're pinning it all on. Going into a deciding fifth. Simple stuff at the moment for Dian Til. They're getting their side outs with ease. Calling the timeout. to do here now, what they need to happen, which is a good starting point from Hooker's point of view, is get some momentum. Let's get some points on the board. Let's take this to Dentil, see how far we can get in the set, and then if we can't get over the line, see if we can get over the line in the fifth. Zhuting not on court, you may have noticed, and the reason for that is she has hurt her wrist. She saw that strapping she had on her right wrist. She's had a strapping on her right wrist for years, as I said, almost part of her costume. But it's giving her a lot of trouble. And so as a result of that, she's not on court, which is a load of Chanqing. Treatment. She might be able to come back for the fifth set. One player who won't be coming back for the fifth set for Chanqing is the starting libero, Liu Liwen. Got the ball in the face in the first set. Into her left eye, completely closed up now. So she's not playing. The backup libero is doing an excellent job actually, Meng Xixuan. 13. So Tim Court, Chanqing on a very different side. Good dig again, well played. And the gator from Fegare, Fawcett gets blocked. Here's the comeback ball for Chanqing. Concern is going to ignore that one. Good up. And again, Chanqing fighting hard. Denying Dentil at the moment, and it's set point now for them. For the set. Fegare kept in play by Fawcett. Free ball now for Chanqing as they try and stay in this set. Braylin makes a good touch. Another chance for Chanqing. Two front court options. But now Dentil have a swing chance. Fegare once again does it with the tip. And the set goes to Dentil. 25-16. It's 2-all here in Shaoxing. We're going to a fifth set decider. Gentil served well, blocked well, attacked well. It's now a race to 15. No technical timeouts, team change ends. Off to a good start in the fifth set. We've seen as vital. He's only got 15 points to play two. He's going to make a good start. Gina got two sets to nothing lead slip. Until they're on a high coming into this deciding set. Destiny Hooker. Change Tianjin's destiny here. Victory in this World Cup Championship. It's their opening match, 3-2 to Navarro. After being 2-0 up, they find themselves in a similar position here. Away we go with the fifth and deciding set. Tianjin with the serve, Dentil looking for that side out, and it's the youngster Wang Yizhu with the serve. Wang Yizhu, having come on and replaced Xu Ting, has hurt her wrist. Receiving treatment. That is just the start that Tianjin wanted. Lee Yin putting that one away. Great point at the very start, but do you know what? The worst thing about it is, from Tianjin's point of view, it's actually the same as a side out point in its value, because it was the first serve. This is now where a break point will be big. And they're going to get a free ball at the very least here. Chance to go 2-0 up. And the roll shot will do it. That's a big break point. Xu Ting, you can see not only that little bit strapping, but now the whole of the right arm strapped up. She's back out onto court, but won't be playing any part. As we see that shot again from Li Yingying. Suffering two injuries to starting personnel in this match. Will it cost them the match? That's the question. Good touch. Oh, that's a massive hit. Well, I don't think it's caught the court. Just from the hooker's point of view, it was a little bit in front of her. She was chasing after it. Another ball's win away from the net towards her. First point now to Dentil. Carroll with the serve. The touch from Fegre and from Fabian, but it's from Braylin, but it won't be coming over.
That one.
one doesn't look to have found the court. A couple of errors from Tianjin, just like that. Game changes until our level. Only on the level. Tianjin have to side out. That's generally deemed to be easier after just made a mistake. I've got a feeling. It's a little bit of pressure. Force it might go after Liu Yingyi. She does, but it's a good pass because there are options here. And the slide behind it. Oh dear, Fei Grey must have thought that was going, eh? Hooker's at one. So that's right, so who's in the wrong spot?
You, number one, number nine.
One and nine are in the wrong place. So Hooker was the wrong side of the Ying Ying. It's a cheap point to give away. Not such a good place to do it here in the deciding set. In fact, it must have been that Hooker was in front of Liu Yingying, should have been behind her. No, that shouldn't matter because they're not on the they're not opposite each other. It must be they're actually the wrong side of each other. Right now, that's a quality swing, and no wonder they're enjoying it. They like the shots like that. Sue Ellen. Claudinia not quite able to make the second touch and keep it in play. Is that off the block? Yes, it is. It's caught railing. So it's just she's looking for something, whether a net touch or block touch. They're looking for a block touch. Doesn't matter what's on the screen, that was always going to say it's wrong. Look like they're turning this around, don't they? This would be something special. Especially when you've got Destiny Hooker on the bench, you've got Xu Ting on the bench, starting Libros on the bench. Thank you. Dorsey thinks it's in the lines. Jones says out. We'll go to challenge. The ball like that, getting that spin on it, it's taken away from the line as they're hitting through it, was an issue. Some valuable time wasted in so much as just taking the sting out of what Tianjin are doing, and now Paul Barris calls a timeout. Those of you who are eagle-eyed may well have spotted Chen Zhongji in the crowd watching this one, the former women's national team coach for China, who guided them to gold in Athens in 2004. The first Olympic gold medal for over 20 years. Standers at the moment looking on to see whether or not their team can get their first victory. Oh, there's a net touch against Tianjin, against Lin Yingying, as Fawcett puts that one on the floor. Tianjin need two side outs to get the victory. Fawcett's going to go back and rip a few jump serves as she can. Got the block out, it's off the block and down and in. Dintil take the point. Tianjin. Fabulous ace serve from Fawcett. All square.
Top,
forcing again. It's another big serve. Braylin's on top of that, but it's really well kept in play. Fantastic dig. And again, but it won't stay in play this time, despite the best efforts of Meng Xishuan. Dentil now have a match point. A match that has swung one way and then the other. Finally, is it going to swing in favour of Dentil? Force it with the serve. That's a good ball in. And that's a really, really good side out under huge pressure. Li Yingying rolls it into the corner, 14 all, and we'll keep on going until somebody can get two clear. Now they have one. Huge pressure here on Braylin. Will she get this for a swing to stay in the match? The serve to come from Yang Yi. He's come on with a nice destiny hooker. It's a good serve, Braylin, to keep Dentil in it. And now Tianjin have a swing for the match. Li Yingying kept in play. And again. And she's done it! She goes with the tip cross-court. There was nobody home to play, and the crowd go wild. And Tianjin have saved themselves from another consecutive 3-2 defeat by winning 3-2 against Dentil. They were 2-0 down. They were pegged back to 2-all. They saved match points in the fifth, and they have taken it 16-14 to get their first victory. With Su Ting injured, with Destiny Hooker on the bench, Tianjin still came up with the goods. What a fantastic game of volleyball. Joy for the youngster, and hardly unsurprising, is it? He cut off the shooting and really dropped in at the deep end. Wang Yizhu has been an absolute superstar in helping the team towards that victory. Momentarily, confirmation of the scores. What a game. Tianjin taking the first two, Dentil the next two, and then Tianjin saving match points to take the decider. This is the stats for that last set. Still opportunities for Dentil to take it. Overall, look at over 104 points each. But it's not a bad point. It's a bad set. It's 3-2. What a game. Su Ting has to say.
Su Ting, what an amazing game, what an amazing performance of your team. But what does this victory mean to you and to your team?
Yes,